my name is Josh. That's Jenna. And it's time for another edition of I Teach My Wife Sales Evening Edition. How do I know that? Because my wife is drinking Merlot.
Organic Merlot.
Organic Merlot. We have had the same landscaper for 7 years. If you were to call me and you were a competitive landscaper and you said, do you have any problems with your lawn? I would have said, absolutely not. If you would say, are you happy with your lawn surface? I would say, absolutely. And yet, we switched landscapers recently.
Yes.
Let me tell you what happened, and more importantly, what this has to do with sales. I wasn't home when we got the knock on the door, the cold call, if you will. Jenna, what happened?
So I got a knock on the door, and this gentleman was there, and he said, would you mind if I take a few minutes of your time? I'm the landscaper. I do some yards around the corner, and I just want to show you some things that are going on in your yard. I said, of course. So I went outside, and he pointed out that some my palm trees were leaning on my roof, and I had branches and leaves that were clogging the gutters. I had a family of iguanas living on my roof. He also pointed out that the leaves from the tree in the front yard were completely filling up all my shrubs. There were dead plants in there, and it all needed to be cleaned up and it needed some love.
He didn't ask Jenna about a problem. He actually pointed out a problem, and because he did, Jenna actually had him take care of it, and he was awesome.
He did an amazing job.
Amazing job. And then afterwards, I saw his work. I was talking to him, and he said, hey, who's doing your lawn? And I told him I'd had the same guy for 7 years, and I was a little disappointed that he wasn't taking care of this. He goes, I would love to earn your business. Here's what I would do differently. And he told me all the things he would do differently, but he was double the price.
Right.
Even though he was double the price, because he was so much better, made me so much happier, and was like loving. Like,
yeah, he really had like a passion.
A passion
for our yard.
And it wasn't just about the money.
He was very nice.
I would rather have paid double and had him do the job because it was better work. It was made my lawn more awesome. So that when people pass
by
it,
they're
like, oh my God, whose lawn is that? And yeah. I wanted that feeling. So we actually switched providers. Jenna, what did this have to do with sales?
That, you know, sometimes you have to show up with a solution, not just a cure and a problem. You have to, he knocked on the door with a solution and to a problem I didn't know I had.
Yes. Don't be a problem asker, be a problem finder. So you can use some different phraseologies in your email, right? Hey, Josh, are you aware that if you run in sneakers that are not made for pronated feet, that you can get injured on long distance runs? That's going to make me think a little bit about my current solution, called an illumination question. They get your prospect to think differently about what they're currently doing to get the job done. So don't be a problem asker. Be a problem
solver.
Nope. Finder.
Finder.
There you go. Be a problem finder. Nice job, hon.
Thanks,
Cheers to everyone.